art even conforms to this model. Before Pokemon Go, it wasn't that people weren't walking along the street looking at their phones. It turns out they were. So here's just an activity that you can do instead of that. So it is important to kind of like ask yourself like why Pokemon Go has been as successful as it has been, and certainly requiring the smallest amount of behavioral change is important. But as Chris was saying earlier on the previous panel, it is a game that's built, been tested for the last 3 years. Right? So Ingress has laid a lot of the foundation for this product. It literally required, as a no new atoms, to get a breakthrough experience. It leverages and extends a behavior that we do all the time, namely kind of like looking at our phones. Something that I think is underestimated in Pokemon Go is that it brings people together in the real world, and it really does turn out that humans like that. You know, when we think about humans, and certainly humans in the game space, we have this image of the dude living in a dungeon, probably with a VR headset on. But actually, real humans do like to spend time with one another, and Pokemon Go affords them the ability to do that, whether that's friends or families. That's really quite powerful. And then, probably the most important thing of why Pokemon Go is it's fucking Pokemon, right? Pokemon is 20 years old this year, right? And it's known literally by everybody under age 35.